Rohini College of Engineering and Technology. I am Vetrivel, Associate Professor, Department of Physics, Rohini College of Engineering and Technology. In this video, we are going to discuss about the concept of hysteresis, which is in the Material Science, page 8251. Course outcome. Upon completion of this course, the students will be able to interpret the concept of hysteresis. Now let us see what is hysteresis. Actually, hysteresis takes place during the magnetization process. So what is magnetization process? We know the ferromagnetic materials will be easily magnetized. That is the process of converting an ordinary ferromagnetic material into a magnet is called as magnetization process. So in this magnetization process, we are applying an external magnetic field that is represented by H to the ferromagnetic material so that the magnetism is slowly induced inside the ferromagnetic material, that is given as B. B is represented as magnetic induction. So, due to the application of the external magnetic field, the magnetism is induced inside the ferromagnetic material. As a result, the ferromagnetic material will be easily magnetized. But the important thing, the value of the magnetizing field H and the magnetic induction value B will not be the same. They are lagging with each other. Lagging means they are not equal to each other. That is, when the value of the external magnetic field H is maximum, the magnetic induction value will be minimum. On the other hand, when the value of the external magnetic field H is minimum, B is maximum. At the same time, B is minimum, H will be maximum. So in this way, they are lagging with each other. H is maximum, B is minimum. Or H is minimum, B will be maximum. So this lagging is represented by a curve. And that curve is called as the hysteresis curve. And the cycle of magnetization process is called as the hysteresis loop. So that is clearly given in this video. When a magnetic material is taken through a cycle of magnetization, the variation of B, that is a magnetic induction value, with respect to H, that is the value of the external magnetic field, can be represented by a closed curve. In other words, the lagging of magnetization behind the magnetizing field is known as the hysteresis curve. Now let us see the hysteresis curve. So this picture clearly shows the relation between the magnetizing field or magnetizing force and the magnetic induction value B. In this graph, the origin is taken as O, that is the center, and the value of the external magnetic field values, they are plotted along the x-axis, and the magnetic induction value is plotted along the y-axis. Now, when the external magnetic field H is slowly increased, the value of magnetic induction value B is also gradually increased. So due to the increasing value of H, B value also increased and reached the maximum value A, that is represented by the letter A. So that is a saturation value of B. When H is maximum, B also reached maximum, that is represented as saturation in the graph. Now, when the magnetic field value H is gradually decreases. Now the important thing, when the H value gradually decreases, the B value will not decrease rapidly to zero in the original path. Instead of that path, it takes new path. It gradually decreases, but it will take another path from A to B. B is in the y axis. So now let us see, even though the external magnetic field value H reached zero, the magnetic induction B value will not be zero. That means H is zero, B is maximum. When H is zero, the ferromagnetic material retains some quantity of magnetism inside the material. So that magnetic induction value is called as a residual magnetism. And this value of magnetic induction B, when the magnetic field value H is zero, is called as the retentivity. So in the graph, the value OB is called as the retentivity. Okay. Now, if you want to remove this residual magnetism value B, we have to reverse the magnetizing field along the negative x-axis, and the value gradually decreases. The H value minus H value gradually decreased. As a result, the value of magnetic induction, which is also gradually decreased. Now H value is increased along the negative x-axis, at the same time B value decreased gradually, and it reached zero at the point C. The value of magnetic induction B reached the point C, whereas the magnetic field value H has a particular value, but the magnetic induction value B is zero. So there is a lagging. When H is maximum, B is zero. So now the residual magnetism becomes zero due to the application of the external magnetic field along the x-axis. So that is represented by OC along the negative x-axis. So this value of the magnetic field H, when the magnetic induction value B is zero, is called as the coercivity. So these two factors are very, very important one. Now the magnetizing field value H is gradually increased along the negative x-axis. The B value also increased and reached the maximum. So that is called as a saturation along the negative direction. Now once again, the magnetizing field value H is gradually decreased. Now the B value also decreased and reached the point E along the negative y-axis. Further increasing the magnetizing field along the positive x-axis, the B value also gradually decreased and reached zero value at the point F. Further increasing the magnetizing field value, B value also increased and reached the point A. So this cycle of magnetization is called as a hysteresis curve. The actual path of the curve, or the actual path of the loop, is given as O, A, B, C, D, E, F, A. So during this cyclic process of the external magnetic field H and the induced magnetism B value, the material is slowly converted into the magnet. So that is clearly given here. If a magnetizing field H is applied to a ferromagnetic material, and if H is increased to H max, the material acquires some magnetism. So the magnetic induction capital B also increases, and represented by OA in the above figure. Now the magnetic field is decreased from H max to zero, the magnetic induction will not fall rapidly to zero, but it falls to B rather than zero. This shows that even when the applied field is zero or removed, the material is still acquires some magnetic induction OB, which is so called residual magnetism or retentivity. Now to remove this residual magnetism, the magnetic field strength is reversed and increased to minus H max, represented as OC, so called coercivity. Hence we get the curve BCD. Then the reverse field minus H is reduced to zero and the corresponding curve DE is obtained, and the further increasing H to H max, the curve EFA is obtained. So during the magnetization process, when we apply the external magnetic field, the magnetism is induced inside the ferromagnetic material. As a result, the ferromagnetic material is slowly converted into the perfect magnet. That is represented by the closed loop that is called as the hysteresis loop or hysteresis curve. Thank you.